When do you do bypass surgery then?
Well, ideally, you'd like to never do bypass surgery. I mean, when a patient says to me, should I have a bypass or I have angioplasty or stents, when do I decide to do a bypass? Mm-hmm. Most surgeons, and there's no controversy, it's not like a surgeon and a cardiologist are fighting for a case. If you come to St. Francis Hospital, the surgeon sometimes will say, hey, you know, guys, why don't you do stenting? It's, you know, it's less risky. Mm-hmm. A surgeon doesn't want to have a complication. So clearly there's less risk with angioplasty stenting versus bypass. What's the difference in hospitalization between the two? First of all, if you come in for a stent, you come in that morning, you may go home that night, you go home the next day, back to work the next day. That's great. The pain is minimal, maybe a little pain at the groin site, but it's really a minimal in terms of pain and discomfort, and you get back right away. Now, who wouldn't want to do that? I mean, you know, it's like...
Now,
what's surgery? So surgery is I do the angiogram, and I look at the angiogram, and I say to you, you know what? I do angioplasty, but it's not going to work for you. It's not going to work long term. You're going to be back here in 3 months. I'm not going to get a great result. I'd love to do it for you, but it's not the right thing for you. The right thing is surgery.
What will show you that you won't get a right good result?
When I do
the history?
The angiogram. When I do the angiogram, I can look at the anatomy of the arteries, and I can tell if the stent's going to work. So while I'm doing the angiogram, if I can fix you, I'll fix you right there with a stent.
Right.